Hello friends, now we are going to start new project ASP.NET library management system, because I got lots of emails from students that please submit this ASP.NET library management system video. So now we are going to start that. So I am going to explain you functionalities. Frontend, we are going to use ASP.NET C#. In backend, we are going to use SQL Server and we are going to use Visual Studio. We will use theme with Bootstrap, so this way website will look 100% responsive, and also you can easily understand that how to implement Bootstrap in ASP.NET. You cannot use Bootstrap easily with ASP.NET, simply like PHP. You need to consider something when you are going to use Bootstrap with ASP.NET. So I will show you how we can use this. So our website will look like 100% responsive. It means mobile friendly. Now I am going to explain you functionalities. We are going to cover below functionalities in this project. We have mainly two part. One is student and one is librarian. You can consider librarian as an admin also. So student can register. We will add a captcha in registration form. So also you are getting idea how you can add a captcha in registration form in ASP.NET. After registration, student account will activated after verify by librarian. Means if student register, then librarian will verify account and then student can login. Otherwise student cannot login. Then we are going to cover student login form, means student can login. And also we are going to add forget password page. For forget password, we will send email with link, and using that link student can add new password. We are going to use this type of link. You can see recently when you are going to do forward password in any website, then you are getting one link in your email. When you are going to click on that link, on that time one page is open, and from there you can change your password. So we are going to use like this, means totally professional. Then student can update their profile and student can change password. Student can search book and student can download PDF and video if available. Yeah, we are going to add one more functionality, like when librarian is going to add new book, on that time is going to add PDF file, also video. If book video is available, then so student can download that also, if available, then otherwise not. Because some people don't like to read book directly, hard copy, so they can use this PDF file for reading purpose. Student can see their taken book with details like book submission date, book issue date, and also penalty. Yeah, penalty is going to set by librarian. I will explain you later that. Student will get notification if librarian send any message, and also student can give reply of that librarian message and log out. So we are going to cover this functionality in student side, and librarian side we are going to cover functionality. Librarian can login, librarian can add new book detail with PDF and MP4 if available. Then if librarian add PDF and MP4 in any book, then this book PDF and MP4 can download by student. Librarian can edit book detail, librarian can delete book detail, librarian verify student detail and approve student account and blot student account. If librarian feel that this student activity is not good, then librarian can block student account, and also librarian can approve student account, then student can login. Librarian can issue book to student. Librarian can add return book in stock, means student book return functionalities. Means when student is going to return this book, on that time librarian can calculate penalty, and also when librarian submit this book, on that time stock will increase. Librarian can see all book with stock. Librarian can search book. Librarian can search student also. Librarian can see that how many students have books right now, because hundreds of students take book and librarian want to take the list, how many students have books right now, then librarian can see that. Librarian can send message to student regarding their book pending to student, so student can get notification also. Librarian can find book as per publication name or author name. Now admin, it means librarian, librarian can set per day penalty. Example, if librarian set $1 per day as a penalty and student submit book 10 days after submission date, then student have to pay $10. So this is totally dynamic. If librarian set $2 per day, then student have to pay $20. Or a librarian set any type of cent, then as per calculation student have to pay, and then load out. So we are going to cover these functionalities in our project, and main thing is that we are going to use totally Bootstrap. So we are getting idea how we can use Bootstrap in ASP.NET also. Thank you so much. If you like my video, then please like it and share it. Thank you so much again.